Now, quickly we are going to learn about the how to use GA for calculating global optimum value for place as well as size. For that, we have to obtain PL size as well as it corresponds to place as well as size. Main capacitor PLCSZ means place as well as size. There is not much difference, but only difference in GA. That is, here the we have to give the number of capacitor 2, but we don't know where we have to keep those capacitors. Let's find using genetic algorithm which one will be the buses and which one will be the size. That is, the number of capacitor 2, that means there will be two places, always two sizes, so altogether our value is 4, 2 into n cap. For one capacitor, there is two variables, one is size and one is place. So for two capacitor, that is 2 into n cap, that is 4. Now, there is a little bit different from that distribution load flow cap and distribution load flow capacitor place and size. That is used only while operating. Nothing more than that. Okay, see. Here, in case of previous one, from global corresponding bus number is also sent as a global variable. But here that is sent from capital place and size, that is sent from the GA itself. And as I have already mentioned, there is only difference that here size as well as place comes from not any other, but it is forecasted by the GA itself. Now, one thing I want to share with you that here we can see that lower one and upper one is given. Lower one is 2, size for size 0. Again, for bus, that is 2 and size 0. Upper limit is 33 and for size, it is 2. There is no any n colon. That is, there is no any nonlinear constraints, but there is an integer constraints. That is 1 and 3rd are the integers, because first is also place, second is corresponding size. First one and third is also place, and fourth is the corresponding size from third one. So here we have given the integer, that is the variable which is comes in first place is a integer variable, the variable which comes in third place is a integer variable. So bus is given by 1 and 3, as well as size is given by both 2 and 4, and in kilowatt it is multiplied by 1000 for finding in kilowatt, as well as loss is also in kilowatt, we have to multiply by 1000. After that, we can calculate voltage level and etc. So let's run this. There is the only difference, that is while updating, there is one difference in distribution load flow capacitor size and place, because both size and place are sent from the GA itself as an argument of the. And here also the main thing is that the objective functional value is active power loss. So we can use that, because our the active power minimization is the main goal. Since the GA is the minimization problem, so it minimizes the that of the active power loss. Let's run this program. Now here we see that the load genetic algorithm is running. Our motive is to find the optimal placement and as well as size for 33 bus system. These are also called the simultaneous. finding a place as well as size using GA. So figure one is the before genetic algorithm. Now here we can see that the voltage profile has improved. Let's see. And also 189, there is 141. That means when we place two capacitor, there is the reduction of power loss. So now if we are going to place two capacitors, then we must have place one capacitor at 12 bus, another capacitor at 30 number bus. And corresponding size are 465 and 1063 kVAr. And the corresponding loss will be 141.84 kilowatt. So like this, we have calculated the optimal placement of capacitor both simultaneously place as well as size using genetic algorithm. I hope you will learn the GA after seeing this video. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.